Welcome, everyone. Today, we are going to learn more about God and His Word. Why is the Bible so important, you may ask? Well, the Bible tells us what is true about God and about ourselves. All of the stories in the Bible fit together to tell us the big story of how God rescued sinners through His Son, Jesus. Bible, there are many main questions we like to answer. The question for this week is, what is worship? The answer, worship is celebrating the greatness of God. Let's look back at the last couple of weeks to remind ourselves what we have been learning. We are tracing the steps of the Israelite people after God has rescued them from Egypt. God has shown that He has provided for them through sending them manna for the people to eat. God has been the great teacher that has given them the laws they are to obey and live by. God has shown that His character is full of mercy and grace, even after the people made the golden calf to worship. God has revealed that He desires to dwell with them and be the center of their lives when He gave them directions of how to build His tabernacle. Today, we are going to hear from the book of Leviticus about why God deserves our worship. Whether this is your first time or your 10th time hearing this story, there is always something new to learn in God's Word.
God gave Moses many laws to show His people what holy living looks like. God is holy, and He wants to be with His people. But the Israelites could not keep God's laws perfectly. God gave His people rules about how to live, how to worship, and what to do when they sinned. One day, God met with Moses at the tabernacle. The tabernacle was a place where God met with His people and where they worshiped Him. God told Moses, "Speak to the Israelites and tell them what to do when they bring an offering to me." Then God gave Moses rules about offerings. Offerings are gifts people give to God, such as money, grain, or animals. Different types of offerings were needed at different times. God also gave rules about the priests. Now, priests made the sacrifices that God commanded. The priests took care of the tabernacle, and they taught people God's rules for holy living. Aaron and his sons served as the priests. God gave them rules about how to offer sacrifices. And when people wanted to praise God, they gave burnt offerings. God deserves our praise. The Israelites praised God for bringing them out of Egypt. When people wanted to thank God, they gave grain offerings. God deserves our thanks. The Israelites thanked God for providing everything that they ever needed. When people wanted to celebrate God, they gave fellowship offerings. God deserves to be celebrated. The Israelites celebrated God for dwelling with them, and they honored Him as their king. When people wanted to say that they were sorry for a sin, they gave a sin offering. God is honored when people turn away from their sin and turn back to Him. The Israelites needed to make their relationship with God right again. So the priest gave an offering so the people could be forgiven. God deserves our worship. He created us to be in relationship with Him, and He's provided salvation from sin through His Son, Jesus. We can worship God by loving and obeying Him as we live to give Him glory.
God deserves our worship. He created us to be in a relationship with Him, and He has provided salvation from sin through His Son, Jesus. We can worship God by loving and obeying Him as we live to give Him glory.
Hi there. I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Today we have a question from a group of boys, Dawson, Mason, and DJ from Glacier View, Alaska.
Why did the Israelites have to kill animals for sacrifices?
That is a great question, boys. You see, since Genesis chapter 3, when Adam and Eve sinned, we've needed a way to be made right with God. You see, their sin separated us from a holy and righteous God, but God, in his love and kindness, put for us a system of cleansing from sin in place that actually required the sacrifice of animals and not us paying the penalty for those sins ourselves. You see, Christ was killed for us. Christ laid down his life for us. And so the old system in the Old Testament where people had to repeatedly bring animals before the Lord to sacrifice day after day and year after year and feast after feast and celebration after celebration, Christ has paid that complete penalty for us. See, God loved us so much that he sent his only son to us, for us, to lay down his life and pay the penalty for us. Jesus Christ, much like the animals of the Old Testament, actually absorbed the punishment and the consequence that you and I deserve for our sin. That's how much Jesus loves you. That's how much he loves us. So, how do you feel when you think about Jesus taking the punishment you deserve for your sin?
Let's read our key passage together. Come, let's worship and bow down. Let's kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, the sheep under his care. Psalms 95, 6 through 7.
Kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God and we are.
Let us pray. God, you are worthy of all worship. Thank you for the salvation and forgiveness we can have through Jesus. We pray that our lives will bring you honor and glory. Amen.